Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's use Automator to create a handy app that will automatically convert an image to a smaller size. So we're going to run Automator, and in Automator we're going to choose an application. We're going to make something that we can drag and drop a file onto, and that would be an application. We're going to choose that, and then we're going to use the actions over here in the library to create something that will take a file we drag and drop onto the app and create another copy of it that's a smaller size. It's constrained to a smaller size. It might be a better size for emailing or uploading to a social media website. Now let's make a plan first. What we want to do is not to actually alter the original image. We want to make a copy of it, and then we want to alter that. But we also want the copy to be named correctly. So there's actually three things we want to do. First is to duplicate the file. The second is to rename it so it has a name that we want, because we know if we duplicate something in the Finder we just get space and the word copy after the name. And then we want to actually scale it. So we can use the library over here to narrow down things, or we can just simply search for them. So let's search for duplicate. And we can see we can find duplicate Finder items. So let's go and drag that over here. And you can see it's going to take the files and folders as input to the app, and then it's going to make a duplicate copy of them. So far so good. So next we want to take the result of this, which would be the files that have been created, and rename them. So we can see we can have it rename Finder items. Let's drag and drop that underneath here. And it warns us that it's going to change the the name, so would we like to make a copy of them? We don't want to. We've already duplicated the files. So we're going to go in here, and you can see it's going to default to add date and time, which isn't what we want to do. But fortunately there's a set of options here. We're going to replace text, and we know that the text that we want to replace is the space copy in the base name before the dot in the extension. And we want to replace that with something like maybe dash small. And now so far it'll duplicate the Finder items, and it'll change the name from, say, image space copy dot jpeg to image dash small dot jpeg. And finally we want to scale the result here. So let's look for scale, and we can see there's a scale images, and we can drag that here. We don't want to add the duplication again because we're already doing that. We can scale to size or percentage. So percentage will shrink the image, but what we really want to do is scale to size. We want to make sure that it's 640 wide or tall, whichever one would be larger. And for any of these you can always look at the options and things in the description to find out more about exactly what it's going to do. So you have options there. So now we've got this complete set here. It'll duplicate the file, it'll replace the copy in the name with dash small, and it will scale the images so it's no larger than 640 pixels on any side. Now we're going to save, and we've already selected application, so it's going to save it as an app. So we'll do resize image dot app, and we'll save it here on the desktop, and you can see it saved here as an application. So now I've moved the app and also an image into this folder called resize so I can test it out. And I'm going to take this photo here, and we can see that the photo is actually quite large. It is down here we can see 2048 by 1536. We're going to drag and drop it on the Resize Image app, and we can see that it creates this file here. You can actually see it through the steps if you look really quickly. It appends the dash small to it. It leaves the file extension unchanged and the rest of the name there unchanged, and we can see that if we get info on this that it is 640 by 480 now. Now the cool thing about this app is it takes whatever you throw into it. I can throw in four different photos here. So I have four photos. I'm going to drag and drop them to the app, and you can see it's going to duplicate all four of them, change the file name for all four of them, and it will resize them. So now I can look and say here's the original size for this one. You see more than 3000 pixels across, and the small version is 640 across. And you can even see the file sizes significantly different here. So you can actually batch change files using the same app that we just made. So I hope the script is useful, but I also hope that it gives some insight in how you can use Automator to do something that you need it to do. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.